Good morning, children. How are you? I hope you are doing well and good. Okay, children. In our previous classes, you have already learned the properties of additions. Let us revise once again the properties of addition. The properties are three in addition. The first one is commutative property and associative property, and third one is addition of zero. Let's see what is that properties. And first one is commutative property. It is also called order property. If the order of the addends is changed, the sum remains the same. Addends, we know already what is addends. And a number is to be added, that is called addends. And adding numbers are we called it addends. And if the order of the addends is changed, if we are changing the order of given numbers, the sum remains the same. That is the property of commutative. Let's see that is right or wrong. And we have two numbers, 23 and 54. Let us add these two numbers, 23 plus 54, that equal to 4 plus 3 equal to 7, and 5 plus 2 equal to 7. Okay, the sum is 77. Let's change these orders, 54 plus 23. Now here, first we add ones place, 4 plus 3, 7, and 2 plus 5, 7. That means we get the same sum. That means therefore 23 plus 54, that equal to 54 plus 23. This is the statement of commutative property. If we add the number or changing these orders, we get the same sum in commutative property. So this is the statement of commutative property. Let's see another example. Two, four, six, eight plus 29. What is this sum? 9 plus 8, 17. 1 carried away, and 6 plus 2, 8, and carry number 1, and that is 9. And next 4 and 2. We get the sum is 2497. Let's change these orders. 29 plus 2468. Same here also, we get the sum is 2497. So the sum is remains the same in commutative property. So what is this property? Yes, if we are add given numbers in any order, we get the sum is same in this property. It is also called order property. Let's see the next one, associative property. What is associative property? If three or more numbers are added together, the sum remains the same even if the grouping is changed. If three or more numbers are added together differently by grouping, we get the sum is same. Let's see the examples, 340, 253 and 99. Let's add, first we are grouping these two numbers. 340 plus 253 plus 99. First, we are grouping these two numbers. Let's add these two numbers, 340 and 253. And that is 3, 4 plus 5, 9, and 2 plus 3, 5. We get the sum is 593. So, right here, 593 plus 99. Now, 593, 99. And 3 plus 9, 12, and 9 plus 9, 18, and 19. Next, 5 plus 1, 6, we get 692. Now, let us change their grouping. Now, grouping these two numbers, let's see what happening. 340 plus 253 plus 99. First, we are add this grouping numbers. So, 253
plus 99, 9 plus 3, 12, and 9 plus 1, 10, 15, and 352. So 340 plus 352, that equal to, let's add these two numbers now. 352 plus 340. 2 plus 0, 2, and 5 plus 4, 9, and 3 plus 3, 6. We get 692. Now, let us grouping first and last numbers. Now, we are grouping these two numbers. 340 plus 99 plus 253. First, we are adding these two grouping numbers. 340 and 99. 0 plus 9, 9. And 4 plus 9, 13. And carry one number, 3 plus 1, 4. 439 plus. And remaining number is 253. Now, we are adding the given sum to the another number. And 439 and 253. Now, let us add these two numbers. 9 plus 3, 12, carry 1. And write here 2, and 3 plus 5, 8, 8 plus 1, 9, and 4 plus 2, 6, we get 692. In these three methods, we get the same sum, 692, here also same. So that means if you are changing their grouping, we get the same sum. Here first we are grouping these two numbers. Next we are grouping these two numbers. And finally we grouping these two numbers. But finally we got the same sum. So this is the property of associative. If the three or more numbers are added together and the sum remains the same, even if their grouping is changed. We are adding the given numbers by grouping them differently, we get the sum remains the same. That is the associative property. And next one is addition of zero. And what is this property? Let's see. If you are add zero to any number, we are adding zero to any number to zero, we get the sum is remains the sum is number itself. For example, 8392 plus 0. We get the sum is 8392. Why 0 means nothing is there. So now 0 plus 6, 2, 5, 3 and sum. So we get the same sum is 6, 2, 5 and 3. That means any number is added to 0 and 0 is added to any number, we get the sum is number itself. Here the sum is number itself. Here also the sum is number itself. So this is the property of addition of 0. Okay children, these are the properties of addition. And first one is commutative property, it is also called order property. And second one is associative property. And third one is addition of zero. Okay children, I hope you are understand what's the properties of addition. Okay, next I'll give you homework on these properties. Okay children, this is your today's homework on properties of addition. I hope you are understand what's the properties of addition, and note this homework and do this yourself and put it on WhatsApp. Definitely, regularly I'll verify your homework. Okay children, we will meet in the next class. Bye.